Welcome to Catalyst Kids at Home. My name is Sarah and I am so glad that you are here with us for our preschool church service today. Now I want to give you a huge hello welcome to say hello. Why don't you see if you can give me a big wave welcome back? If you get your hands ready, give them a wiggle. Ready, steady, wave! Wonderful. Now today, I have a special book with me. Do you know what this is? This is a Bible, and the Bible is God's good book. Now, Bibles come in all kinds of different shapes and sizes, so you might have a Bible at home, but it might look a little bit different to my one. In fact, if you do have a Bible at home, why don't you run as fast as you can? Grab it, bring it back to the screen and give it a big wave in the air. And big people in the room, if your child does not have a Bible and you would like them to have one, then you can download the Bible app or the Bible app for kids from any app store. It's amazing, 10 out of 10, would recommend to a friend. Now, all month we have been learning about how to have and grow faith. And the Bible is full of things that can help our faith seed to grow big and strong. So what we're going to do just now, we're going to read some things that are in the Bible. And we're going to have a practice to help our faith seeds grow big and strong. If you jump to your feet, there's going to be some actions you can copy along with. Let's open the Bible and see what it has to say. The Bible says to listen to God's word. God's word is the Bible. So the Bible says to listen to the Bible. Can you wiggle your ears? Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Can you do a big listen? Very good. The Bible says to pray to God. Prayer is just when we chat to God. Can you go chat, 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 chat? We can chat to God anywhere, anytime, about anything. In fact, why don't we chat to God right now? Sometimes when I pray, I choose to close my eyes really tight to help me concentrate. And sometimes I even put my hands out like this to say, God, I need you and I want you. Let's pray. God, would you help our faith seeds grow big and strong? Would you help us to trust and obey in you? Amen. Amazing. Let's see what else is in the Bible. The Bible says to wait with a good attitude. Can you put your hands on your hips and wait? And can you wait with a good attitude to give me a big cheesy smile? Cheese, cheese. Very good. The Bible says to obey my leaders. Can you go like this? And the Bible says sing to Jesus. I love it when we sing to Jesus. When we do that, that is called worship. You know, we're going to worship right now. We're going to sing and dance because God is so, so good. So why don't you jump to your feet, get ready to worship. I'm going to be wearing a special cape in this song. So if you want a special cape to wear when we worship too, why don't you grab a blanket and tie it around your shoulders. Let's worship.
Days a week, I can count on God.
worship and sing to Jesus, our faith seed can grow bigger and bigger and bigger. Now, another thing that was on our list to grow that faith seed bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger was listening to God's word, the Bible. And every week on our Bible adventure, we learn a new special part of the Bible and we say it over and over and over again with actions to help it stick in our heart and in our head. And this month, we've been learning a part of the Bible from Psalm 31:14. I wonder how many of you at home can remember what that verse is. Wiggle your fingers if you think you can remember it. Well, we have the incredible Eden and Esme from our Mearns Church site who are going to show us how it goes. If you think you can join in and follow along with them, wiggle your fingers, get ready, here we go!
Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God, you are my God, you are my God.
Great job! Here's a wee high five through the screen just for you. Now, we are about to go on our Bible adventure and hear even more about how our faith seed can grow big and strong. So, if you're ready, on your marks, get set, go!
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Wiggle my waggle!
Hi friends, I'm Emily. Shine the Star sent me the question, how do you show faith? I'm going on a Bible adventure to find out! Shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me. Woohoo! Let's put on our adventure bags.
Woohoo! Wee! Hiya, friends.
Hi, Shine. We're getting ready for our Bible adventure.
Did you pack your picture passes?
Not yet. What's in my trunk?
Oh, I know. The first one is something that has numbers on it and tells the time.
Friends, which picture pass is it? The clock! Open your adventure bags!
Okay, this one's inside your head. You think and remember with it.
You're right, as a green light! The brain! Put it in your adventure bags!
Now for the last one. When you add water and sunshine, it'll grow.
What could it be? A seed! A seed grows! We've got them all! Count them with me, friends! One, two, three! Let's zip our adventure bags together! Now it's time to fly! Whoa! Whoa! Shine, I read the question, how do you show faith? But I don't know what faith is.
Faith is trusting and believing.
Trusting and believing? Maybe our picture passes will help. We have a clock, a brain, and a seed. Oh, Shine, I still don't get it.
Then let's watch a story from the Bible that's all about faith.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
Abraham's big test. That's from the book of Genesis.
I've heard of Abraham before. He was a real person who lived a really long time ago. Friends, maybe Abraham can show us what faith means.
God promised Abraham a son, and from that son, many descendants, who would bless the whole world. But Abraham and his wife Sarah were too old to have children. 20 years went by. Still, Abraham trusted God's promise. When he was 100 and Sarah was 90, God reminded them of his promise. Sarah was going to have a baby. When their son was born, Sarah was so joyful that she laughed. God has brought me laughter, she said. So they named their son Isaac, which means he laughs. When Isaac was a boy, God tested Abraham by telling him to take Isaac to Mount Moriah and kill him as a sacrifice to God. Abraham was confused, but still he trusted God. Isaac carried the wood, and Abraham held the knife and torch. Together they climbed the mountain. Where is the lamb for the sacrifice? Asked Isaac. God will provide it, Abraham replied. Abraham arranged the wood on an altar, tied up Isaac, and laid him on the wood. As he raised the knife to kill Isaac, an angel called his name. Abraham! Don't hurt the boy, the angel cried. God knows you trust his promise. Look, there in the bushes, a ram is caught by its horns. Sacrifice that instead. So Abraham sacrificed the ram instead of his son. He called the place God will provide, because God provided the sacrifice. Just as God had said, his promise came true.
Did you see how Abraham trusted and believed?
Yeah, God told Abraham that he was going to give him a son. Abraham believed God, and God kept his promise.
Abraham trusted and believed God, so he obeyed God to show faith.
Obey? Obey! How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey. Whee! That's the answer to the question.
I wonder if Blinky and Cloudette know about faith.
I don't know. I'll go find out.
And I'll find out about these picture passes on our Bible adventure. Come on!
Oh, that Abraham, he sure showed some faith. Oh, hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy.
Look at this.
What is it? What is it?
I just learned in my favorite book, the Bible, about a man who showed a lot of faith.
So did we.
What? You did?
Yeah.
Friends, who do you learn about with Emily?
It was Abraham. But we still don't know what it really means to show faith.
Faith. Let me see. Ooh. Faith means trusting and believing.
That's what Shine said. But how did Abraham trust and believe?
Remember when God made a promise to Abraham?
Yeah. God told Abraham that he would give him a son, even though Abraham and his wife Sarah were too old.
But he had faith. He trusted and believed God the whole time. And God gave him a son when he was 100 years old.
That reminds me of one of our picture passes. Count them with me, friends. 1, 2, 3. Great. Now, which one has numbers on it and tells the time? It is the clock.
A clock reminds you to show faith in God by waiting, even if it takes a long time.
I think I need a Bible verse to help me remember to trust God while I wait.
Oh, I have one. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, watch first.
Okay.
Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God, you are my God, you are my God! Okay, repeat after me.
Okay.
Psalm 31:14.
Psalm 31:14.
I trust. In you, Lord. I say. You are my God, you are my God, you are my God!
You are my God!
Okay, great job, friends. Now, let's do the whole verse together.
Yeah.
Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say. You are my God!
Jumpin' jambalaya! When I have to wait, I'll trust God. He is my God.
Trusting God is a way to obey.
That reminds me of the question. How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey.
I'll remember that on our Bible adventure. Bye, guy.
See ya.
Come on.
Ooh. I can't share. It's just a box anyway.
But I heard Mr. Stone say you had to.
Blinky, what's in that box?
Oh, all right already.
Oh la la, bubbles. Let's play bubbles.
No bubbles.
Why are you being so selfish?
I just super dee duper love bubbles. If I share, you guys will use it all up, and I'll have to wait forever.
Wait? For what?
Well, to get more bubbles, of course.
But Mr. Stone told you to share.
Yeah, and he said he'd give me more after they're all gone.
So what's the big deal?
What if Mr. Stone forgets? Then I'll never get any bubbles.
Blinky, you need to have some faith in Mr. Stone. Trust, believe, obey.
Trust, believe, obey?
God is so good. He gave you Mr. Stone to take care of you.
Yeah, God did give me Mr. Stone to take care of me when Mommy's busy. I know he loves me. I really do trust him. But I'll be so sad if I don't get more bubbles.
Abraham felt like that, too. He knew God loved him. He trusted God. But do you think Abraham wanted to give his only son back to God?
No way. That is too sad. Abraham shouldn't do that.
Abraham did do it because he had faith. He believed, trusted, and obeyed God.
Shine, Abraham lived a long time ago. That's why he could be so brave and obey. I'm just a little bug. I can't do it.
You can because God put a tiny faith seed in your heart when you ask Jesus to be your leader. It'll grow every time you remember God is real and loves you.
I think I feel that faith seed growing right now. I can trust and believe God.
Whee! Claudette!
Whee whee!
I'm gonna share all my bubbles with you guys. I'll show faith in God by trusting Mr. Stone and obeying.
Yay!
Well, now we know what the clock's for. We show faith by trusting and believing in God, even when we have to wait. But what about the other two? Say them with me, friends. A brain,
and a seed.
Do you hear that? It sounds like it's coming from Mr. Music's singing studio. Let's go. Mr. Music! Oh boy, I'm sure glad that you're here. We've got to ask you a question.
Ask away.
How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey.
Yeah, that's the answer. And Guy the Bible Guy taught us this verse to help. Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God, you are my God, you are my God.
Wow, that verse reminds me of a man in the Bible named Abraham.
Yakety yo-yos, we know about him.
Do you remember when God asked Abraham to give his son Isaac back?
I do remember that part. It was sad and kind of scary.
Yes, but Abraham had faith in God, so he obeyed God.
Mr. Music, why did Abraham have faith to obey God?
Because Abraham remembered that God kept his promise to give him a son.
Remember! That reminds me of one of our picture passes. Whew! Count with me, friends. 1, 2, 3. Now, which picture pass is it?
It's something inside your head. You think and remember with it.
The brain! Abraham used his brain to remember the promise God kept.
When Abraham was scared or worried, he remembered what God did before and believed that God would take care of him again.
Can we do that too?
Sure you can. In fact, I know a song that'll help. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Do you want to sing it from the beginning?
Yeah!
Okay, here we go. Repeat after me.
Okay.
I want faith like Abraham.
I want faith like Abraham.
When I can't, I know God can.
When I can't, I know God can.
Why should I be scared or worried?
Why should I be scared or worried?
I know that my God is with me.
I know that my God is with me.
That was great! Here we go.
I can trust my God, I can trust Him and obey. I can trust Jesus, I can trust Him and obey.
F-f-f-faith.
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 That was great. Here we go.
When a problem comes my way.
When a problem comes my way.
I can look to God and pray.
I can look to God and pray.
And why should I be scared or worried?
Why should I be scared or worried?
I know that my God is with me.
I know that my God is with me.
Yeah!
I can trust my God. I can trust Him and obey. I can trust Jesus. I can trust Him and obey. I can trust my God. I can trust Him and obey. I can trust Jesus. I can trust Him and obey.
F-f-f-faith.
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 Faith, 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 faith.
That was great! Now, stand up on your feet to worship God with singing, music, and dancing.
I can always count on Jesus.
Jesus loves me. 4 and 5, he's by my side. 6 and 7, he's the way to heaven. 8, 9, 10, sing it again. I can always count on him. I can always count on Jesus. Gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that he is with me every day. He's by my side, he hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in him. I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout.
The Bible Guy taught us a verse about faith. Say it with me, friends. Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God, you are my God, you are my God.
So faith means you'll trust God and believe he's always your God.
Yeah, and the verse helps us remember the answer to the question. Ask us the question, Shine, ask us the question.
How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey.
Whee! And the picture passes?
Count with me, friends. 1, 2, 3. The clock helps us remember to trust and obey God, even when we have to wait a really long time. And the brain helps us remember what God did before, so we can trust and believe God now. But, Shine, what about the seed?
When
When you choose Jesus as your leader, you get a teeny tiny seed of faith in your heart.
Well, if it's so tiny, how will it help me trust and believe God more?
Like a seed, faith grows. Every time you trust, believe, and obey God, it's like giving water and sunshine to your faith seed.
Well, what'll a tiny faith seed grow up to be?
It'll grow into kind, loving actions. When your faith grows big and strong, your actions will help other people trust, believe, and obey God too. God promises to help you grow your faith. Pray to God, and He'll keep that promise.
Let's do that right now. Okay, bow your head and close your eyes. We're gonna talk to God together. Dear God, help us to show faith. Give us patience. And help us remember the promises that you've kept and grow our faith seed. In Jesus' name, amen. Great giggling geckos, it's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Great giggling geckos, what a delightful Bible adventure that was. I wonder if you know the answer to Shine's question, how do I show my faith? I show my faith every day when I trust and obey. And when we trust and obey, our faith seed can grow bigger and bigger and bigger. And remember, God's good book, the Bible, when we read God's good book and listen to the words it says, our faith seed can grow even bigger and bigger and bigger. Now, it is about time to say goodbye for today. Coming up next, there is going to be some questions on the screen. So remember to pause that, and you and the people in your house can enjoy those all together. But before that, I have loved getting to have Sunday with you all today. Shake your hands high in the sky if you've enjoyed it too. Woohoo! Coming up next, one of my good friends is going to pray with us and say goodbye today. So I'm going to say goodbye, and we're going to put a big smile on, cheese, and say a big hello to the incredible Carly from Ellen.
Hello! I'm Carly! I'm from the Ellen site. I'm so excited to be able to chat to you today. I've got some helpers. This is Ethan, and this is Kyle. Are you happy to be here?
Yeah.
We also have some props. We have two clocks. They are, aren't they? Clocks.
Yeah.
And these were some of our picture passes today. So we thought we'd spend a bit of time and think about that. The clock was used to remind us that we need patience. Patience to show that we trust and we can obey God. That's quite hard. What do you need patience for, Ethan?
Snack time.
Patience for snack time. What do you need patience for?
Dinner
time. Oh, food orientated here. We need patience maybe to go back to school and see our friends. Abraham had lots of patience, didn't he? He waited a long time to have his son. 20 years, in fact, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think we should pray for patience this week. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Let's get comfortable. Dear Lord, thank you for our wonderful preschool children. Thank you for their patience during this time. Help them to be patient in lots of different ways every single day, Lord. Thank you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Bye, everyone.